وأقول في القرآن ما جاءت به آياته فهو الكريم المنزال وأقول قال الله جل جلاله والمصطفى الهادي ولا أتأول
الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على عبد الله ورسوله نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Welcome to another installment from Ramadan Daily Droplets, where we take one particular benefit every single day that relates to the month of Ramadan and we share it with you and we look at the various aspects of it and the ways that we can benefit from it. And our benefit that we'd like to share with you today is the statement of Allah Azza wa Jal, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا ارْكَعُوا وَاسْجُدُوا وَاعْبُدُوا رَبَّكُمْ وَافْعَلُوا الْخَيْرَ لَعَلَّكُمْ تُفْلِحُونَ O you who believe, make ruku' and sujood and worship your Lord and do good so that you might be successful. Allah Azza wa Jal tells us about worshipping Him in the salah through the ruku', the bowing, the sujood, the prostration, and all of the other forms of ibadah. And then Allah Azza wa Jal singled out the doing of good, and particularly here, the doing of good to other people. Being good for other people, and doing good for other people, and being a source of good for other people. وَفَعَلُوا الْخَيْرَ لَعَلَّكُمْ تُفْلِحُونَ Do good to others so that you might be successful. And Imam al-Sa'di rahimahullah ta'ala, he said, فَلَا طَرِيقَ لِلْفَلَاحِ سِوَى الْإِخْلَاصِ فِي عِبَادَةِ الْخَالِقِ وَالسَّعِي فِي نَفْعِ عَبِيدِهِ فَمَنْ وُفِّقَ لِذَلِكَ فَلَهُ الْقَدَحُ الْمُعَلَّى مِنَ السَّعَادَةِ وَالنَّجَاحِ وَالْفَلَاحِ Imam al-Sa'di rahimahullah ta'ala, he said, there is no way for a person to be successful. Remember Allah Azza wa Jalla said, لَعَلَّكُمْ تُفْلِحُونَ So you may be successful. There is no way for a person to be successful except by sincerely worshipping the Creator and striving to benefit the creation. Look at the beautiful way Imam al-Sa'di brought these two things together. This ayah is about sincerely worshipping Allah and doing your best to benefit the creation. Be a benefit for them. Do good towards other people. He said, so whoever is given the success to do that, this person will have al-qadah al-mu'alla, they will have al-hadh al-awfar, the greatest portion of happiness and al-najah, success, and al-falah. They'll win, they'll be successful, they will succeed, and they will be truly happy when they sincerely worship Allah alone and they do their very, very best to benefit and be a benefit towards other people and do good towards others. And Zayd ibn Khalid al-Juhani, he narrates from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, مَنْ فَطَّرَ صَائِمًا كَانَ لَهُ مِثْلُ أَجْرِهِ غَيْرَ أَنَّهُ لَا يَنْقُصُ مِنْ أَجْرِ الصَّائِمِ شَيْءٍ The hadith narrated by Imam al-Tirmidhi, which he said, whoever gives the iftar to a fasting person, he will have the like of their reward, without their reward being decreased in anything, without the reward of the fasting person being decreased in anything. SubhanAllah, this is just one way from the multitude of ways in Ramadan that you can do good for other people. To give someone food to break their fast, and you get the reward of their fast, but they don't lose the reward of their fast in anything. وَفْعَلُوا الْخَيْرَ لَعَلَّكُمْ تُفْلِحُونَ Do good to others so that you may be successful. And there is a hadith from Abi Huraira in Sahih Muslim, مَنْ نَفَّسَ عَنْ مُؤْمِنٍ كُرْبَةً كُرْبَةً مِنْ كُرَبِ الدُّنْيَا نَفَّسَ اللَّهُ عَنْهُ كُرْبَةً مِنْ كُرَبِ يَوْمِ الْقِيَامَةِ وَمَنْ يَسَّرَ عَلَى مُعْسِرٍ يَسَّرَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ فِي الدُّنْيَا وَالْآخِرَةِ Whoever makes it easy for a believer, whoever helps a believer out of a difficulty, from the difficulties of this dunya, Allah will save that person from one of the hardships that are there on Yawm al-Qiyamah. And whoever makes it easy for a mu'sir, for a person in debt, whoever makes it easy and lets them go, gives them time, Allah will make it easy for them in the dunya and in the akhirah. وَمَنْ سَتَرَ مُسْلِمًا سَتَرَهُ اللَّهُ فِي الدُّنْيَا وَالْآخِرَةِ. And whoever conceals the faults of a Muslim, Allah will conceal his faults in the dunya and the akhirah. وَاللَّهُ فِي عَوْنِ الْعَبْدِ مَا كَانَ الْعَبْدُ فِي عَوْنِ أَخِيهِ. And Allah will help a person to the extent that that person helps their brother. Subhanallah. وَفْعَلُوا الْخَيْرَ لَعَلَّكُمْ تُفْلِحُونَ. Do good to other people. This is how you're going to be successful. Your sincerity to Allah, your ruku', your sujood, your salah, and you strive and you go out there to benefit and be good to other people. Allah Azza wa Jal will help you to the extent, in accordance with the extent to which you help your brothers and your sisters in Islam. And there is a hadith of Abdullah ibn Amr ibn al-As, and it's narrated in Tabarani and others. The Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, إن لله عبادا اختصهم بالنعم لمنافع العباد يقرهم فيها ما بذلوها فإذا منعوها نزعها منهم فحولها إلى غيرهم. There are servants that Allah has. Allah has chosen for them to receive blessings so that they can benefit other people. Allah Azza wa Jalla has given them blessings, whether it be wealth, whatever it might be. Allah has given that to them for the purpose of benefiting other people, helping out other people. Allah Azza wa Jalla allows them to live this blessed and luxurious existence as long as they spend upon people and they use it to benefit other people. And when they prevent the people from it, Allah takes it away from them, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives it to someone else. And subhanAllah, that's the danger, that ultimately all the wonderful things that you have, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave you these things for you to benefit from and for you to benefit other people with. And when you stop benefiting other people with them, perhaps Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would take them away from you and give them to someone else. And not only that, but doing good to other people is a reason to be prevented from calamities. There is a hadith of Abi Umama, and the hadith is narrated by Al-Tabarani and others, in which the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, صَنَاعِعُ الْمَعْرُوفِ تَقِي مَصَارِعَ السُّوءِ وَصَدَقَةُ السِّرِّ تُطْفِئُ غَضَبَ الرَّبِّ وَصِلَةُ الرَّحِمِ تَزِيدُ فِي الْعُمَرِ. He said that doing acts of goodness, صَنَاعِعُ الْمَعْرُوفِ, acts of kindness, prevent calamities, evil things from happening, calamities happening to you. And secretly giving sadaqah puts out the anger of the Lord. It extinguishes the anger of the Lord. And keeping ties with your relatives extends your life. SubhanAllah. Doing little, small, good actions, it can prevent huge calamities from happening. A small thing you do, tiny thing you do, you might not even think about it. A very small good that you did to someone else, a small act of kindness that you did to someone else, could prevent a huge calamity from happening to you. We know that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, أفضل الأعمال إدخال السرور على المؤمن كسوت عورته أو أشبعت جوعته أو قضيت له حاجة. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, the best of deeds is to bring happiness to a believer by covering his awra, i.e. by, you know, buying him the clothes or giving him clothes to cover his awra, or relieving him of his hunger, and giving him food until his hunger is relieved, or fulfilling a need that that person has. أفضل الأعمال, the best of actions you can do. And look at this month of Ramadan, how many opportunities are there for you to do good. وَفْعَلُوا الْخَيْرَ لَعَلَّكُمْ تُفْلِحُونَ. Do good to other people so you may be successful. How many opportunities are there this Ramadan for you to do good to other people? And here we have a wonderful story, and the story is a story related to Imam al-Hasan al-Basri rahimahullah ta'ala, that he sent out ba'atha qawman min ashabihi fi qada'i hajatin li rajul. he sent out some of his students or his companions to fulfill the needs of a particular man. He had a need, something that he needed, and he sent them out for that. وَقَالَ لَهُمْ مُرُّ بِثَابِتِ الْبُنَانِي فَخُذُوهُ مَعَكُمْ. He said, pass by Thabit al-Bunani, the great narrator of hadith, rahimahullah ta'ala, and take him with you, bring him along with you. فَأَتَوْ ثَابِتًا, they came to Thabit, فَقَالْ أَنَا مُعْتَقِفْ, he said, I'm in itikaf. فَرَجَعُوا إِلَى الْحَسَنِ فَأَخْبَرُوهُ, they went back to al-Hasan al-Basri and they informed him that Thabit says he's not going to come because he's in itikaf. Thabit, he said, say to him, يَا أَعْمَشْ أَمَا تَعْلَمْ أَنَّ مَشْيَكَ فِي حَاجَةِ أَخِيكِ الْمُسْلِمِ خَيْرٌ لَكَ مِنْ حَجَّةِ. He said, go and tell him, don't you know that you going out, walking out to fulfill the need of your brother Muslim is better for you than performing a hajj. فَرَجَعُوا إِلَى ثَابِتْ فَتَرَكَ اعْتِكَافَهُ وَذَهَبَ مَعَهُمْ. And then they went back to Thabit, and they told him, and Thabit left his i'tikaf and he went out with them. SubhanAllah, perhaps the goodness that you do for other people this month of Ramadan might be better for you even than the acts of worship that you were engaged in, or some of the acts of worship, voluntary acts of worship you might be engaged in. So don't lose the opportunity this Ramadan to do good to other people. وَفْعَلُوا الْخَيْرَ لَعَلَّكُمْ تُفْلِحُونَ, and do good to others so that you may be successful.
Assalamu alaikum. If you're enjoying these videos and you'd like to keep up to date with all of the courses we're going to be running, make sure you head over to amauathome.com.